Hey, what's going on, everyone? This is Dalton at Dalton895 coming to you with another Transformers Speedia, or Velocitron Speedia 500 video, and that is going to be the Diaclone Universe Clampdown. So now we have our final one, I believe, for the Lamborghini mold. So, Hasbro, please, no more. No more after this. Unless there's some weird... Unless they want to do Shattered Glass, then I'll be fine with that. I guess Armada... Wheeljack too, so maybe make those the last two. No more after this. I know a lot of people are tired of this mold, but if they were to do those two, I wouldn't complain, even though I am getting tired of this mold. This mold has been more used, I think, more times than any of the Seekers have, except for the Classics mold at this point, I think. Anyways, there you go. It's a nice look at character art. Back 16 steps. He has a police car instead of a fire chief car, so... There's that. Let's go ahead and get them open and check them out. And here we have Clampdown in vehicle mode. And, well, I mean, out of the packaging, I mean, he's packaged in vehicle mode. But, I mean, he's looking pretty good. Like, not really much else to say. It's pretty much the same as Red Alert. And here is Red Alert. So, see the similarities between the two. There is a slight difference in the white coloring, which, you know, matches up with the spoiler that I got for him. Of course, there's a lot more black paint here going down the back of the legs, which I've already heard people saying that they're going to swap the legs on these, and I'm kind of tempted to do that myself. I mean, it is just a mushroom peg, so we could try that out, but you'd end up losing the star and black markings here, or you could just swap out the thighs. And maybe this outer, well, I guess same. It'd still be missing this rest of the stripe and the police badge there. You can see similar markings like we'd see on Prowl. And light bar is the same, except you got the silver paint instead of just the white paint. But for the most part, they're fairly similar. Now, I did also get an upgrade kit from Non-F, though I did paint the spoiler itself silver because I felt like that would pop a little bit more, give him more of that kind of Diaclone look as well. And then instead of, you know, the stock rocket launcher and rifle, I went ahead and bought a toy accurate launcher and rifle for him. So you got that going on. But yeah, transformation is just the same as we've seen before. With these added spoiler pieces, you just want to rotate them downward towards the front of the car. Of course, open up these panels here, these panels on the side. Bring that up, and these will rotate forward. Bring down the feet, just close that up. Rotate the upper torso. Then split the legs, open up the arms, bring them out, and fold away those panels while lifting up this one, folding it down, and then flipping out his hands. And there we have Clampdown in robot mode. Of course, give him his, we'll go ahead and go over the stock ones first. Shoulder launcher and rifle. So you got that. And here is his mold mate, Red Alert. Now, I did swap the arms on this Red Alert just to make it look a little bit more accurate, especially with the stickers on the doors. But yeah, it is the Siege arms on the Kingdom body. I just think it looks better. Slightly off, but not too bad. And... you know, I know a lot of people aren't too happy about the gray thighs, but I kind of dig it. It's a nice little update for him. And I actually do quite like this rifle that he comes with, so I just got that one. But swapping that out for the more toy-accurate launcher. And, yeah, I mean, he looks pretty good. Now, all the joints are still fairly good and tight. Knees are a little on the loose side, but not too bad. Definitely pretty good on the QC side of things with this release. So there he is. here is the G2 sideswipe. Here's his fellow officer, deep cover. Another Diaclone member, Tiger Track. And of course, the original sideswipe, or Kingdom sideswipe. So, these are the versions I've got of this mold. I do have the Siege versions, but they are in storage, as well as the regular Red Alert forearms. But yeah, having Earth Mode, Sideswipe, Alert, and Clamp Down, really nice. I would have preferred if, you know, Deep Cover was using the Earthrise mold, but I've got Toy Hacks on that, so. Or at least, you know, for the roof and... I think that's it. And then the spoilers. So yeah, he's close enough to Earth Mode for me with that. So yeah. So just comparing the two police Diaclone members. I mean, for the most part, pretty good. So yeah, for the first of the Velocitron stuff, and you know, managed to get him before he sold out. He is also one per case, much like Cosmos. I'm still trying to get Cosmos at the time of this recording. My local store has him, but they are taking their sweet time putting out the modulars for the King or the Velocitron stuff. Like, it is in the back. I tried asking. They said, no, we can't do that. We'll get in trouble. So, as much as I think that's a lame excuse, I understand. And yeah. But that being said, hope you guys enjoyed this quick look at the Legacy Velocitron Clamp Down. Let me know what you think, if you think you should have had the red thighs like Red Alert, or if you like this new gray thighs look. I personally don't mind it. I don't have a huge attachment to the Diaclone character. I never had the Masterpiece or the E-Hobby release, so personally I think it's fine. I just wanted to change up the blaster so it didn't have just this sticking off. I mean, you can still use it, like maybe this could be like a, maybe you could use it as like a nightstick or something, like a baton. So, just put it on his forearm there. So you can still keep him fairly armed. But yeah, let me know what you think of the Legacy Clamp Down. I know some people are tired of this mold, but hopefully this is the last one. I don't know. I don't want to give them any more ideas, but I kind of want to see that weird blue to lime green repaint G2 sideswipe. I know some people are getting the Toy Hack set to turn Siege sideswipe into GoBots, you know, the little spy changer sized Optimus Prime, which I think is neat. But honestly, don't know what else they could do with this mold other than retire it. So I also have Gigawatt, but not important for this video. So, hope you guys enjoyed. I'm still rambling, so once again, let me know what you think of Clamp Down, if you're getting them, if you're gonna pass. And yeah, I'm looking forward to looking at the rest of these Velocitron figures, so I'll see you guys next time. Actually, I don't know why I'm doing that. I've been making it a point to go back to vehicle mode, so we'll go back to vehicle mode, then we'll end it there. So, how about that? I'm just wanting to get these videos done. I mean, it's not that I don't care. It's just I'm also on a time crunch. Trying to get these all out before, or recorded before BotCon. And I forgot to keep those out. Fold that up. I mean, you guys have seen this transformation dozens of times by now. But why not show it back and forth? There's always someone that could be coming. I don't know why they'd come to this video first, but hey, never know. Someone that could be experiencing this mold for the first time, and my channel could be the one that they go to watch a transformation. So there we go. There is Clamp Down. I still love the silver that I did for that. It's the Tamiya Silver Leaf Spray. It's not 100% perfect match, but I think it works well enough, especially for the police car mold, or the Lambo police car look. So So yeah, again, let me know what you think. Be sure to check out all my other legacy videos and the upcoming Velocitron ones if I can keep my camera under control. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time.